So you're asking how to surrender.
Yes.
If I say you can surrender by jumping from that hilltop, you won't take the advice, right? It would be a foolish advice if I say that. If I say you can surrender by jumping into leaping flames, that is again an advice that you won't take and would sound foolish coming from me. We are discussing the question of how to surrender. So this how to can obviously be nothing that you cannot do or that which you would not do. When you ask how to surrender, you are surely asking for a method that is acceptable to you. If I say you can surrender by jumping from the hilltop, this may be a method, but you will not use this method because it won't be acceptable to you. So even when we are asking for methods, we are asking for methods that are
acceptable
to us. Now who is this me that will decide on the acceptability? Who is this me? This me is you. This me is exactly the you that you want to get rid of by surrendering. So you are saying, I want to surrender by using methods. I want to surrender the self by using methods that are acceptable to the self. Now such methods, will they be helpful in surrendering or will they rather continue the self? But that is what is so wrong with all methods of surrender and meditation. You will only choose the method that is acceptable to you and is thereby acceptable to your ego. There are so many methods, right, sir? We all love particular methods. We say it is my personal choice to meditate using this method and that method. Have you ever gone into why you choose a particular method? And why you won't choose the method of jumping from the hilltop? That is a method. And I'm assuring you, it is a very powerful method.
But it exists.
It exists, yes, of course. I've tried it many times. It's a very nice method. But would you try it? You won't try it because you don't like it. You would only try something that you personally like. And this person that likes and dislikes is exactly the one who needs to be surrendered. So can there be a how-to involved? Can there be a how-to? Just surrender. Surrender is not an art. It is not a skill. It is not a task. It is this. When you spoke, I surrendered to you. Only by surrendering to your question could I listen to what your heart is asking. And when I speak, you have to surrender to me to really know what is coming through me. That is surrender. Easy, simple, obvious, so damn straightforward. Surrender is not something exotic, not something far-fetched, not something there in some other galaxy. This is surrender. Surrender. Right now, you are in surrender. And when you speak, I must listen in surrender. And when I speak, I must speak in surrender. Surrender just means that the person who likes and dislikes is not too important for me. I can take her a little casually. I can treat her almost like a joke. So even as I speak to you, there is a person here who is reminding me of the breakfast. But right now, the movement towards breakfast is surrendered. The fellow who is asking for food cannot be taken seriously. This is surrender. So as you will climb to the hilltop this afternoon to jump, there would be a person within you who would be saying, don't do that, you might get just a little hurt, you know, a few injuries here and there. You should not take her very seriously. Just go and jump. Are you getting it? That is surrender. Don't be so particular about what you have been doing. Don't be so adamant about what you will do. Let things happen. Let things happen. The person is a dictator. He says, no, I know everything. I will decide. You have to sometimes, you know, pinch the dictator in the behind and run away. And he will get furious. But then you can hide under the bed and do something, and then when he has forgotten and is again busy with his dictatorship, you can again go pinch him in the back and again run away. That is all the respect that the person deserves. You don't need to kill him. You only need to pinch him a little.